is going on, Governor? It's Chisgule here, and today we're going to provide a full commander guide on the newest commander, Theodora, who might be one of the very best city garrison commanders and Ark of Osiris garrison commanders to enter into Rise of Kingdoms, and she's also an Attila Takeda counter. Hello, my friends, and welcome back. We're going to be doing a full commander guide on Theodora, which you know means we're going to review the skills, the talents, the pairings, and how you unlock this commander. If you like Rise of Kingdoms guides that help you get value and smash your enemies, then consider smashing that subscribe button for daily Rise of Kingdoms videos. We are also a sponsored content creator. Let's review Theodora, who just hit the game, and we've got some predictions at this moment in time for where she's going to be exceptional. She is a leadership, garrison, and defense commander. This is a very unusual combination. We'll talk more about talents in a moment, but that leadership tree, I don't know how I feel about that. Garrison and defense, however, are very, very strong for what I think she's going to be very good at. Defending cities and defending structures, particularly in Ark of Osiris. The first skill is pretty game-changing. She does a circle AoE effect, hitting up to 5 targets for 1,400 damage factor, and for every target beyond the first, you do slightly less damage per target. This is very, very powerful. This is basically Yisong's first skill, except even better. It's got the expertise baked in with just a little bit less damage. Very, very powerful. Where is this good? I think obviously in Ark of Osiris, where you're going to be able to hit lots of targets when they swarm a structure, or also for defending your city if you are getting multi-rallied. Let's continue on to the next skill. When commanding a garrison, all troops under Theodora's command gain 10% defense, and damage taken from rallied armies is reduced by 10%. I really like this for defending your city because guess what? This boost doesn't have a troop type tied to it. So if you're defending your city, you're going to have siege units, archers, infantry, cavalry, all are going to benefit from this very, very powerful skill. I also really like the damage reduction from rallied enemy armies, because if you're an Ark of Osiris, what you want to do is slow down the enemy's attack onto your structure so that you can get there to reinforce, and reducing the damage that you take accomplishes that. The next skill, Co-Ruler. All troops under Theodora's command gain 10% attack. Now, I'm just going to point out that that's not a lot of bonus. Although it does apply to all troop types, 10% attack is a pretty low amount. There is a little bit more to this skill. If your army is at more than 50% strength, then your troops deal an extra 10% damage when this skill is maxed. Where is that good? Defending your city, especially if you're a high-power player, you want to do as much damage as you possibly can to the enemy before they feel compelled to cancel their rally. I think it's really good in that context and less exciting for game modes like Ark of Osiris and certainly for defending flags. I'll point out that 10% attack is really not very much on a skill at all, which is all you're going to get from this skill after you've dropped below 50% strength. And if we just compare to other commanders like Artemisia, they're giving you 40% of stats straight up for archers, which is why I feel she's a commander that is going to do well in situations where you are going to have a bunch of mixed troops, sort of by necessity, defending your city, maybe an Ark of Osiris, but is less compelling for things like flags, even though the area of effect damage is powerful. The next skill when commanding the garrison, each time her troops take damage, there's a 10% chance to gain 40% damage bonus for 3 seconds. Now, at first blush, that sounds pretty gosh darn good. 40% damage, that's your skill damage, that is your counterattack damage, that is your normal attacks. That is very powerful. However, if we just do some basic math on the frequency with which this fires off, assuming there's not even an internal cooldown, this is going to be giving you 40% for 3 seconds. Assuming this is tied to just one army hitting you, then it's going to be giving you a pretty small percent damage boost. It's like 12% all the time is how you could sort of think about that. It's, you know, the 40% times the 3 seconds divided by 10 seconds, which is the amount of time that it'll take on average for this thing to fire up. But if you're getting surrounded and every single army hitting you every single time is giving you that 10% chance to get this boost, then this could be very good if you are getting multi-rallied. It could be very, very good in Ark of Osiris when things are getting swarmed. That's why I really like it in that situation. Now, the last skill is really interesting. This is a super counter to Attila and Takeda. Immediately removes any slow and control effects from Theodora's troops before doing her area of effect damage, basically putting the effect that Kusunoki has onto her, which is really strong in this situation, again, where you're getting swarmed or multi-rallied, which is often true for big cities getting taken down, and of course an Ark of Osiris. I mentioned that it is an Attila-Takeda counter because Attila and Takeda have a lot of debuffs that they apply. Now, I don't know if it clears all of these. We'll have to do some testing to sort of figure that out. But if you look at Attila, he is reducing the attack of the target. He is also reducing the defense of the garrison. If you look at Takeda, Takeda has the Fierce as the Fire debuff, which I have been told from VIP support that, in fact, it will clear the Fierce as the Fire debuff, which is going to remove a lot of Takeda's effectiveness, including the 30% extra normal attack damage is going to be, you know, not granted because the debuff's not going to be there anymore. This is very, very powerful. It's also really powerful against other attackers that could be hitting you. For instance, if you're pairing Theodora with a commander that does healing, sure, will be nice to remove the healing if it in fact does work that way. It'll be nice to remove things like Aethelflaed's debuff. I mean, there's a lot of effects. Heck, even Temeris offering that skill damage taken debuff, perhaps that gets removed as well. I really like this expertise skill on Theodora. I actually think it's quite good. Now, because two of her skills, however, are for strictly the garrison, that is the second skill and also the fourth skill, I do not think she's going to be particularly good in the open field, even though she does have this really nice area of effect damage. I think your Esong is going to be a better pick here, although it is conceivable that at 5-1-1-1, she could be usable even with Esong, although she's really going to be missing a lot of march speed if you try to take her into the open field. Now, with regard to the order in which you invest in these skills, I think there is an interesting insight here, which is that these skills all advance in a linear way. Every point increases the benefits you're getting by an equal amount. And sometimes on commanders, like you could look at Richard I, right, the last couple points are actually much more effective in the second skill and the third skill. Not the case on Theodora. So I think that you can max the first skill, then take her all the way up to 4 stars, and then start to apply points. The only skill that is escalating in a disproportionate way beyond the first is actually her fourth skill, where she's going to get 5% extra damage boost going from level 1 to 2, 5% damage boost from 2 to 3, but then 10% boost going from 3 to 4, and the same again going 4 to 5. So I would max the first skill, take her to 4 stars, apply the points, hope they land over here. And realistically, I mean, this far into the game, you've either migrated to an old kingdom or you are in the realm of needing to have commanders be expertised before they are usable. And I think that will be the case here. This is a commander you're going to want to have expertised before you start using them for things like defending your city or an arc. Let's start to talk a little bit about the talents that you would use on this commander, because this is the first time that we have had a leadership, garrison, defense commander in Rise of Kingdoms. And what I find so strange, so truly strange about the application of the leadership tree is that it is oriented toward rallying stuff. The very most powerful talent in this tree is for rallying stuff, which is not what you're using her for. So I think this is really unusual. I do think there are potentially some compelling talents in the leadership tree, particularly close formation when you are reduced below 50% strength. Getting the 12% attack for 4 points seems like a really solid boost. However, there's really only one talent I'm excited about here, and that is Hidden Wrath. You get 6 rage every time your troops are attacked. This does work if you're getting swarmed, thus giving her a rage engine that is very, very powerful in a game mode like Ark of Osiris, or if your city is getting multi-rallied. I'm not as excited about strategic prowess, in part because you're going to need to get a lot of march speed in order to get there, which are kind of wasted talents once you're in the garrison. Also, she doesn't have any healing, so I don't know what you're doing with healing herbs. I also don't like the additional restriction of armed to the teeth and armored to the teeth. If you're defending your city as well, I think you've got better places you can put your points. Let's talk about where those are. And to do that, we're going to look at Richard the First, who is going to have the garrison and the defense tree. Now, if you were defending in Ark of Osiris, I think this could be a really spicy build, and I've left 6 points behind so that we can get those talent points I was just mentioning in the leadership tree. I like going all the way over to Know Thy Enemy in order to have some nice damage reduction when you're getting swarmed, and you will get swarmed. I like the huge boost to stats in King's Guard, and I like the overall tankiness that you're getting all throughout this tree, reducing skill damage you're taking as well as overall damage taken reduction. And I did pick up medicinal supplies for Osiris because you want to hold on to those structures for as long as possible. You do want to have some healing, but no, I don't think this is enough healing to warrant getting the herbs talent in the leadership tree. If you were defending your city, I would go with this build. We do have 10 points in reserve that you could drop into the leadership tree if you wanted. We're still getting the Know Thy Enemy talents and ducking off the side to get impregnable and nowhere to turn. We also pick up Testudo Formation, Loose Formation, and Balance. I like this build a lot. There is a question about the languaging of Know Thy Enemy. I still don't have a clear answer from the last video that I did on this card up in the top where we talk about how this could be one of the most underrated talents that folks are avoiding for some reason. The reason folks are avoiding it, I suppose I have the answer to that question, is that they're not sure if it is enhancing damage reduction effects or giving you additional damage reduction. The way that it's worded is a little unclear. I'm inclined to believe that if this talent is giving you 6% damage reduction with no downside whatsoever, other than needing to be in the garrison, that if this talent is saying you've got to be in the garrison and surrounded, that the 9% sounds about right as additional damage reduction, not enhancing your damage reduction. But that's enough going deep on that topic. Those are the builds that I would recommend for Theodora. And if I had her, I would put her in to defend my city right now, and I would probably be using this build that you're looking at right over here. Let's jump over and talk about how Theodora is unlocked. She is going to be a Mightiest Governor Commander that is after the Artemisia Commander cycle. So if you're in a newer kingdom, it is going to be a very, very, very long time before this commander becomes available to you, probably to the tune of 500 plus days before you will see her show up. Now, you can use universals on this commander after you've unlocked her, and that is what I most likely will do after all of those Mightiest Governor cycles have concluded. We just finished a 6th cycle of Artemisia, which is insane. The last we had was 5 for the previous commander, and now we had 6 for this one. So if we're getting 6 cycles, that's a lot of opportunity to get sculptures. It will be a bummer to expertise her after the first Mightiest Governor cycle, and then need to compete in more Mightiest Governors just by virtue of being in Kingdom versus Kingdom or whatever, and not getting any value from that. So I'll wait. I can be patient for that. Let's talk about the pairings now, which is very, very exciting. The pairings for Theodora are really actually quite broad. There's a lot you can do because she's not tied to a specific type of unit. There's an upside to that, and there's a downside. The upside is that if you're in a situation where there will be multiple unit types present, then hey, everybody gets a benefit. The downside is that the only situation where you must have multiple unit types is going to be defending your city. Everywhere else, you have a lot of control, and with that control, you can take advantage of sending just certain unit types and benefit from the additional boosts that you typically get to that one unit type if that's all you bring. For instance, I mentioned Artemisia earlier. For cavalry, you've got commanders like Takeda that just give huge amounts of stats, but you must bring cavalry to get any of that benefit. So for that reason, I think she is going to be compelling as an Attila Takeda counter and good as a secondary or primary. Let's talk about some of those situations. And broadly, I'll say that she is good as a primary if there are debuffs you need to clear before you have the secondary commander use their active skill. How would that work? I think it would go something like this. You would have Theodora use her active skill. On either that turn or the next turn, it's going to clear all of the debuffs off of her. There's a turn of downtime between active skills, and then you have the active skill fire off from the secondary commander. Where is that relevant? Well, if you're removing attack debuffs, it's going to be really great to have a high damage secondary like Yisong, who does bring a little bit of a rage engine and also does circle of effect damage and boost the active skill. I think Yisong Theodora is going to be a sick pair for either defending your city or potentially even structures in Ark of Osiris. This is very powerful, especially because they don't really care about archers all that much. Richard I, I think, is also going to be a really compelling pair in Ark of Osiris, and that is largely because now you can have Theodora primary clear off negative effects, potentially including healing debuffs, we don't know for sure yet, and then boom, you get the big heal still, whereas before you'd have a commander like Saladin or Ramses or Alexander the Great really reducing the effectiveness of a commander like Richard I. I think Richard could be back in business with full infantry. Charles Martel, I think, is going to be a fine commander, but not out of this world. I like the elevated counterattack, the dependency on infantry to kind of get to where you're going with this march speed bonus, I think is a constraint that I'd rather not have, but I think they'll be a fine pairing nonetheless. Continuing onward for garrison defense pairs, I do think that Constantine will be a solid pairing. There's a huge amount of stat boost here, and I really like that like both of them are giving large amounts of stat boost to different types of troops, although obviously infantry will be preferred. Continuing on to other garrison commanders, I do think that Artemisia and Theodora will be the strongest pair to defend against Attila Takeda. I think that the insane effectiveness of Artemisia's third skill, reducing the normal attack of Attila Takeda by 10% is massive. That's all they do, so that's a 10% total damage reduction from them. Well, I guess you take counterattacks too, so that's not fair. It's not quite a 10%, it's probably more like a 5% reduction. Half of Attila Takeda's damage is normal attacks, half is counterattacks. Just to get that out there. Okay, and the disabling effect, again, massive damage reduction to Attila Takeda, because look, if they're not hitting you, they're not doing any damage. So that's kind of like a 10% damage reduction as well, because I don't think you can counterattack either when you're disarmed. All that to say, I think Artemisia, also this really counters Attila Takeda on the expertise skill, with Theodora, who's going to be clearing all of those crucial debuffs that Attila Takeda apply, is going to be really powerful. I think area of effect damage is really powerful. And this combo could be really good in a flag as well. And if we see Theodora in flags, I think it's going to be Artemisia and Theodora together as a pair. That AoE damage making it really difficult to be around the flag will be good. And also obviously very powerful as a garrison in Ark of Osiris, or even for your city as a pair. I think they're pretty gangbuster. The next pair that could be compelling is obviously Wu Zetian. Neither cares about a troop type. I don't love that in this instance. I do think that the support tree is the primary, however, using Wu Zetian primary instead of Theodora could be a very solid pick to fire off those skills much more rapidly. I think that there is obviously some very solid synergy here between them. I like that you're silencing targets that are hitting you. I like that you've got high counterattack damage. And I like that there's a chance that those attackers that are hitting you are going to do a lot of damage themselves. I think that this pair could be very good. It'll be one to watch, especially because there's some healing on this skill over here. I would want to keep an eye on that to see just how valuable we find it. Those are the pairs I would recommend at the legendary tier. If you were going to be investing in this commander to pair with Sun Tzu, I think they will do well, even as a city garrison together. Sun Tzu is going to generate a lot of rage, do AoE damage, reduce the damage you take. I think Sun Tzu would be a pretty solid pair. I think it would be overkill to be using Kusunoki for like the double effect of clearing the debuffs, although it's kind of a cute idea. I would avoid it. And I'll be quite honest, if you're this far along into the game, you probably are looking at mostly legendary commanders to pair, or it's going to be that Sun Tzu that we've already talked about for defending your city. Overall, I think Theodora is a powerful commander. I think I perhaps, in the earlier part of the video, underrepresented the potential for Theodora with Artemisia to be the new meta Attila Takeda counter. Meta means most efficient tactic available. I think the two could be really busted good. And I suppose there is one other pair I should mention, YSS, Yi Sun Sin, who I think paired together might make the best possible city defense. He doesn't have quite as much anti-Attila Takeda technology baked into what he does. He's just all around outstanding, which I think is a nice thing to have for defending your city, but we'll be talking about him in a video coming real soon. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Let me know down below in the comments what combination you're most excited about, what you think the potential is for this commander in Rise of Kingdoms to really change the way people play, the way they think about the game. I'm pumped for what we'll be doing with this commander. I would like to pick them up, expertise them, and put them on my wall, but we'll see where we end up investing our sculptures. We've got 1,400 to burn, and now that we've seen these new commanders, maybe we'll give a couple days to see if anything changes about them, but we're going to start spending these down now that we know what the new meta is going to potentially look like. If you enjoyed this, drop a like. Consider subscribing so you don't miss our future videos, including when we're going to cover this guy right over here. And until next time, you have fun smashing the kingdom.